In the 1998 movie Pleasantville, the movie starts in black and white and ends in color. Now, this is just one example of what makes movies so special. Now, let's discuss the movie by looking at some of the scenes and footage. For instance, in this scene, Tobey Maguire is telling these people that there's a world outside of Pleasantville which they did not know.
There are some places that the road doesn't go in a circle.
And he's exactly right, but the people in Pleasantville didn't know that. In fact, they basically know nothing about the modern world. That's why two regular kids go back in time through the TV to tell the old people in black and white that if they want to start seeing colors, they're going to have to start doing things a little different, like having sex and reading books. It's a really cool movie, as you probably remember, with cutting-edge cinematography and excellent themes. Let's explore.
What's outside of Pleasantville?
You see here? Look at those puzzled faces. Again, see, they have no idea what any of this is talking about. You can tell that the director of the movie, Ron Howard, did a great job of telling the actors, in this shot, now you're going to have to look confused.
I don't understand.
You sure don't, ma'am, but...
Outside of Pleasantville?
It's all part of the movie and the director's master plan, Ron Howard. Here she's starting to realize that Pleasantville doesn't quite have the creature comforts she's used to, like toilets. Watch her acting here. Notice her disappointment. You see, it really shows? Now that's one reason actors are so important, because reading facial expressions help us get to know the characters. But my favorite part of the movie is probably when it starts
that?
To rain and everybody freaks out, wondering, what's going on?
What's going on?
It's rain.
Real rain?
Yeah. You don't have rain either?
See here, it's like he's talking to little babies who know nothing. Very cool stuff.
It's okay, it's
another very important technique actors use is called keeping a straight face. Even though what they are saying may sound silly or ridiculous, see how Toby never breaks down and starts laughing? Here's where you feel emotions. Make sure you have goosebumps at this part, or even tears, for it is pure cinema magic.
So how does it end?
Here's the last scene I'll look at.
There are other ways to enjoy yourself without Dad.
It's the famous scene where Reese teaches her mom how to masturbate. After Reese tells her mom to get in the bathtub and feel herself up, pay close attention to the shots and the editing and the music they use. And watch as her husband hears her moan. What's going on, he thinks, huh? It all adds up to make a successful scene of a 50s mom touching herself for the very first time and absolutely loving it. She gets so excited that colors start to appear, including the green swan scene here and this bird in the tree. Needless to say, she goes all the way and it feels amazing. But the only bad part is that it causes their tree outside to burst into flame.
Fire!
Hey, here, grab the nozzle.
Well, where's the cat?
Come on, just hold on tight.
Whoa!
Luckily, Toby does a great job putting out his mom's masturbation fire, and so he gets a town medal. As you can see, his mom feels weird about it, but everyone else is happy. The medal is for showing the firefighters how to turn on their hose, but really it's a medal for showing the whole town of Pleasantville how to see in colors. No, that's what I call movies. Thanks for tuning in. If you like this video essay and love movies, please consider promoting and supporting movies by ordering a hat that says movies on it and wearing it proudly. And see you next time.
Wow.
Where's my dinner?